disorders of muscular and skeletal system. After complete of all the concepts of muscle and muscle contraction and the skeletal system and joints, all we completed. Finally, we are going to disorders. What are the disorders we are associated to the skeletal and muscular and skeletal system? Now we are going to, first one is goes to myasthenia gravis. We called as myasthenia gravis. Basically, we called as autoimmune disorder. This goes to autoimmune disorders. Means immune system, it is selfly attacked to the human body to leads to the type of abnormalities goes to myasthenia gravis. It is attached, this is associated to the neuromuscular joint. Means nerve, the motor neuron, it is motor neuron is where it is attached to the muscle area. In that joint area, this type of abnormality will be takes place. Means that is have a fatigue will be takes place, means weaken and paralysis will be possibility will be there. Next, what happens means basically acetylcholine, we call it as neurotransmitter. Normally we know that acetylcholine is goes to neurotransmitter. That ACH, it is used to the muscular area, the signals is transformed to the nerves to the muscular area. Here muscle area, the where is the receptors of there, that is goes to ACH. Acetylcholine receptors is masked by the antibody or blocked by the antibody. That's why acetylcholine, they should not reach to the acetylcholine receptors of the muscle. That's why the muscle, they should not show any type of movement. That is goes to weaken and paralysis will be there. These type of autoimmune disorders means antibody, basically it is gives the protection from the microbes. But its antibodies block the acetylcholine receptor which are having into the muscle area. That's why acetylcholine neurotransmitter, the proper neurotransmission is not occurred. The blocked by the neurotransmission, this type of abnormality will be called as myasthenia gravis will be there. This is number one. Number two is goes to muscular dystrophy. Means selfly muscles undergoes to disintegration and degradation of muscles. We called as muscular dystrophy. It is one type of genetical disorder. It goes to Duchenne muscle dystrophy. Okay, Duchenne muscular dystrophy. We called as Duchenne muscle dystrophy. It is goes to some genetical disorders. It is goes to genetical disorders. It goes to 18 years. After 18 years, the muscles automatically they go to destruction of muscles. The body gets to the very rigid condition. Very shape is goes to weaken. The bow shape of the body will be formed. All the muscles are goes to degenerates. The type of disease we call as muscular dystrophy, the genetical disorder. Next it goes to tetany. Tetany means the muscle is attached to the particular position we called as tetany. It is involvement of calcium ions or hypo means low availability of the calcium ions. The muscle is goes to, they should not show any type of movement. It is a fatigue stage will be there. We called as a tetany. And it goes to parathyroid hormone also helpful for this type of abnormalities goes to tetany, hypoparathyroid ions. And it goes to hypocalcemia. Hypocalcemia condition also, which is helps to the tetany positions. Next, arthritis. Arthritis means inflammation of joints. Inflammation of joints we called as arthritis will be there. The inflammation will be takes place, the joint we call as arthritis. Next, it goes to osteoporosis. Osteoporosis means calcium ions are removal of the bones, some discharges of calcium ions from the bones, we called as discharges. And finally, the small pores will be formation in the bones. This we called as osteoporosis, means weakened bones, means old age people highly suffering from this goes to osteoporosis. Means calcium ions are absorbed by the body, the bones, basically bones we have the reservoirs of calcium and phosphates. When we muscles get near the calcium ions not available in the food material, the calcium ions can be absorbed by the bones. That's why bones become weakened. That abnormality we call as here osteoporosis. Last one is goes to gout disease. Means joints will be accumulation of uric acid. Joints will be deposition of uric acids to finally formation of a gout disease will be there. These all are the diseases will be associated to the muscular skeletal system. This are goes to myasthenia gravis. Second one is goes to muscular dystrophy. This goes to Duchenne syndrome also. Duchenne muscular dystrophy. It is a genetical disorder will be there. Next is goes to tetani, is the calcium ions, and the parathormone will be helpful. That this goes to arthritis and osteoporosis, and finally formation of a gout disease.